As the town grew, so did the need to educate its children. On October 7th, 1818, Josiah Sutherland issued a deed to the trustees of School District No. 9 in the consideration of the sum of $5, 1.5 rods from the northeast corner of present-day Westlake and Butler Roads, for the sole purpose of a schoolhouse. In 1819, the school was finished, a one-room structure with a large stove at its center and seating for students all around. Soon, the schoolhouse became the center of the community, not just for education, but for social and spiritual activities. A handwritten Christmas program reveals a commitment to community and holiday spirit here in 1901. In 1906, after 87 consecutive years of service, the little white schoolhouse was well-worn and in need of replacement. A summertime Lake resident and local dentist, Dr. Charles Booth, who once attended the little white schoolhouse, took the lead in the creation of a new one. The same Dr. Booth who helped create Kershaw Park and Atwater Fountain would have his hands full as some opposition to the new school grew. But in the end, Dr. Booth won out and managed to raise $900 for the construction. The new schoolhouse was built almost entirely by local carpenter Henry Weller on a rise just above the old schoolhouse, which allowed school to go on until the new one was completed. Frank Benham of Edgewater Farms donated 1 acre of land for the new school, and in 1906, District 9 had a new schoolhouse, deemed by the New York State Commissioner of Education as the finest rural school in the state. On a cold and blustery Monday morning in the fall of 1906, the new building was formally opened. Reverend Lewis Reed, pastor of the Congregational Church, led a prayer, and Dr. Booth spoke of the importance of education to city and country folk alike. Much was made of the new oversized windows and electric lights that would provide 10 times the light of those old 4 kerosene lamps. Fred Cribb, a Supreme Court justice who once attended the little white schoolhouse, cited the advantages of good conditions in which to educate. In the end, 31 boys and girls, grades 1 through 6, who would be the benefactors of such a wonderful school, sang America. In the cold rain, a maple tree that still shades the schoolhouse today was planted. And in the end, pride was the flavor of the day. In the next 7 years, the Rural School District No. 9 became a model for rural schools in the state. In 1954, the new Canandaigua Elementary School opened on Pearl Street, but the small district schools were allowed to stay open. The Westlake Schoolhouse was consolidated into the Canandaigua school system. One teacher, Mrs. Bessie Spike, held a teaching position at the school for 26 years, longer than any other teacher. Devoted to her teaching, Mrs. Spike could claim that 75% of her students would go on to college. Over the years, enrollment fluctuated and questions were always asked if the school could survive. In the 1920s, discontinuance of the school was discussed, but Dr. Booth would again lead the way to stave off that threat by raising a new endowment for upkeep and expenses. In December of 1966, an article in the Rochester Times-Union announced that the fate of the Westlake Road School would be discussed at the next board meeting. It was evident that time was running out for the Westlake Road School. In 1969, 150 years after the original Little White Schoolhouse was built, it was over. In 2006, on the occasion of the Westlake School's 100th birthday, former students got together to commemorate those wonderful times. The school was no longer operational, but the good memories and treasured history will always be alive.
It was just a great place to be. The kids were all close friends, and I know as they would graduate from 8th grade and go away, we'd miss them terribly, but then new young kids would come again. So I was here from the 2nd grade to the 7th grade, and then I had to go down to Union School. Dad sent me down to Union School for the 8th grade. There were 15-minute periods where every student or two, whichever happened to be in the class, would go up to the front of the room, and there were little chairs up there and one chair for the teacher. And she would have a reading class, like for first grade, at 9 o'clock, and then it would be 15-minute period. Then she'd have them go back to their seat, and second grade would come up with one or two students would come and sit in front. The most we had was 21 students at any one time, first through 8th grade, and the least we had was 9 students. And the teacher had to keep on her toes in order to keep everybody studying what they should and get all of their book reading done and homework and everything, and it was quite a time for everybody. Dr. Booth came once a year, and he'd always bring bananas, one for each child, one for each student, and he would encourage us to do our very best. He would talk to us and say that education was so important.